Rosemary felt was not exactly beautiful. No, you couldn't have called her beautiful. Pretty? Well, if you take her to pieces. But why be so cruel as to take anyone to pieces? She was young, brilliant, extremely modern, squeezily well-dressed, amazingly well-read in the newest of the books. Rosemary had been married for 2 years, and her husband absolutely adored her. They were rich, really rich, not just comfortably well off. If she wanted to buy flowers, the car pulled up at the perfect shop in Regent Street, and Rosemary, inside the shop, just gazed in her dazzled, rather exotic way.
Good morning, Miss Frau. You look splendid today.
Thank you.
Oh, how beautiful. Give me those little tulips. I want those, and those. Give me that jar of roses.
All of them, madam?
Yes, I will have all the roses on the jar. No lilacs. I hate lilacs. It's got no shape.
Yes, I also think lilacs are dreadfully shapeless.
That will do for today.
Oh, it's good to see you, madam. I have something that I know you will love, and I save it for you. You see, madam? I love my things, and I don't want to part with them, and sell them to someone who does not appreciate them, who has not that fine feeling which is so rare.
I like it. I love it.
Point out to madam the flowers on the box.
Charming! How? What is the price?
28 guineas, madam.
28 guineas. Even if one is rich. Well, keep it for me, will you? I will.
Of course, madam. I am always at your service.
She was outside on the step, gazing at the winter afternoon. Rain was falling. There was a cold, bitter taste in the air, and the lamps looked sad. Sad were the lights in the houses opposite. Dimly they burned, as if regretting something. Rosemary felt a strange pang. She pressed her mouth against her breast. She wished she had a little box to cling to. Of course, the car was there. She had only to cross the pavement, but still she waited. There are moments, horrible moments in life, when one emerges from shelter and looks out. And it's awful. One shouldn't give way to them. One should go home and have an extra specialty.
Madam, may I speak to you a moment?
Speak to me?
Madam, would you let me have the price of a cup of tea?
A cup of tea? Then have you no money at all?
None, madam.
How extraordinary. How more than extraordinary. Suppose I took her home with me.
And suddenly it seems to Rosemary such an adventure. It was like something out of a novel by Dostoevsky. This meeting in the dusk. Supposing she did one of those things she was always reading about or seeing on the stage. What will it happen? It will be thrilling.
Come home with me and have tea. I mean it. Why won't you? Do. Come home with me now in my car and have tea.
No, you don't mean it.
But I do. I want you to please me. Come along.
You're not taking me to the police station?
To the police station? Why should I be so cruel? No, I only want to make you warm and to hear anything you care to tell me.
Hungry people are easily led. The footman held the door of the car open, and a moment later, They were skimming through the ducts to Rosemary's house.
There! Don't be frightened. After all, why shouldn't you come back with me? If I'm the more fortunate, you should expect. Come and sit down.
Adios, madam.
You look dreadfully cold.
Oh, please, you mustn't be frightened. You mustn't, really. We will have tea and be cozy. Why are you afraid? I'm very sorry, madam, but I'm going to faint. I shall go off if I don't have something.
How thoughtless I am. Tea! Tea at once! And some brandy, immediately!
No brandy. I never drink brandy. It's a cup of tea I want, madam.
Don't cry, poor little thing. Don't cry.
I can't go on no longer like this. I can't bear it. I can't bear it. I shall do away with myself. I can't bear it no more.
I will look after you. Don't cry anymore. Don't you see what a good thing it was that you met me? We will have tea and you will tell me everything. And I shall arrange something, I promise. Do stop crying, it is so exhausting, please. And when do you have your last meal?
Rosemary, may I come in?
Of course.
Oh yes, I'm sorry.
It is quite alright. This is my friend, Miss.
Yes, madam.
We are going to have a little talk.
Oh yes, quite. It's a beastly afternoon.
Yes, isn't it? Vile.
Rosemary, would you come to the library with me, would you? Would Miss Mead excuse us?
Of course she will.
Explain, who is she? What does it mean?
I picked her up in Curzon Street. Really, she is a real pickup. She asked me for the price of a cup of tea and I brought her home with me.
What on earth are you gonna do with her?
Be nice to her. Be frightfully nice. I don't know. We haven't talked yet, but show her, treat her, make her feel...
My darling girl, you're quite mad. It cannot simply be done.
I knew you would say that. Why not? I want to. Isn't that a reason? And besides, one's always reading about these things. I decide.
But she's so pretty.
Pretty? I haven't thought about it.
Good Lord. She's absolutely lovely. Look again, my child. I was turned over when I came into your room just now. However, I think you're making a ghastly mistake. Sorry, darling, if I'm crude and all that, but let me know if Miss Mead is gonna dine with us tonight.
Pretty? Lovely? Philip, dinner is ready. Oh, and Mrs. Smith won't dine with us tonight.
What happened? Previous engagement?
She insisted on going, so I gave the poor little thing a present of money. I couldn't keep her against her will, could I? Philip, do you like me?
I like you awfully.
I saw a fascinating little box today. It cost 28 guineas. May I have it?
You may, little wasteful one.
Philip, am